Hi, welcome to the Stash and Notions podcast. My name is Penelope and we're coming to you from Bacchus Marsh. And today I have a guest with me. Deb, why don't you introduce yourself?
Hi, I'm Deborah. I'm NudeKnit on Ravelry, Instagram and Twitter, I think. So, yeah.
Hey, thanks for joining me today, Deb. And you can find me on Ravelry and Instagram as Miss Red Pen. And this is episode 8. And I haven't got a name for it yet, so let's call it Long Time No See. Since my last episode, quite a lot has been happening. Things probably look a bit different to you apart from having the guest here, because we leveled up in our adulting and bought a house. And
that's beautiful.
Thank you. And that's kind of why I've been off the air, the whole stress of are we getting it, are we buying it, and then getting it, and the whole holy crap, we have this mortgage business now and packing to move and moving out of the rental.
The best Christmas present ever.
It was so much fun. Yeah. So yeah, we had our first Christmas and New Year here. Although I will tell you now, moving 3 days before Christmas
sucks.
Bad idea. Don't do it. If you think you want to be moved before Christmas, you've got to do it like a month before, or just wait. All right.
Nah, if you get the opportunity, jump in. Why not? Should have done it New Year's Eve.
Should have done it. Oh, God. So what's been happening with you, Deb?
Me? Not much knitting this past year. Probably one of my least productive years ever. So I want to start the year off with a bang.
Fantastic.
Haven't knit much at all, though.
Well, on that, let's jump into our first segment. Works in progress. I only have one to show. I haven't actually done that much knitting in the last couple of months with the whole...
What? Moving house? I haven't done much knitting.
But I have been tucking away slowly. This is my Stephen West, is it the Doodler? No. Oh, God.
The Doodler, the one with bits and bobs.
Yeah.
Different patterns.
Hmm.
You can see on the technical one here.
So I am up to the brioche section, and so I am doing my first lot of brioche.
That is so pretty.
Look at that. Let's see if we bring that up there. How
are you finding the brioche?
Getting the two setup rows was really difficult. I had to redo them a number of times. Oh yeah, look at that. But it's only reversible for that section. The two setup rows, painful as... But once you get those going, it's not too bad at all. There's kind of a unique rhythm to it. So once you get... Have you done brioche?
No, I haven't.
So you knit each row twice, but you're only knitting every second stitch. And the other ones, you're slipping them with a yarn over.
Oh, yeah.
And then on the way back, you knit the opposites. And so, yeah, once you're going, it's fine. I think if you do it with one colour, it's called a fisherman's rib or something similar to that. Very similar look, but yeah, it's got a lot of stretch in it.
I reckon you should show the rest of it too, because it's so pretty.
And so
that's good. This is the top.
Yeah, this is okay. Let's see. This will be a good test to see if I can remember the colours. I have mentioned them previously. The first colour, The first colour, the grey, is from Mayhem and Chaos.
Oh yeah, it's a grey blue.
Yep. Isn't that Rockstar?
We might just need to hold that above your head.
The purpley one, number 2 here, that is Malabrigo. The third one, the pinky, lighter pinky one, is what is that one? That is Yarn Versus Zombies.
Is this the right side?
That's the wrong side.
Oh,
that's okay.
Cut. pretty.
and the final one, this is from Wool and Vine Yarns, and this is her narwhal
unicorn.
Yeah, yes.
We don't get Wool and Vine here very much, so
no. I did have to stay up till midnight in order to get the sale, and I just grabbed it.
That's really pretty. Sorry, yeah. I'm just trying to get all of it there for you.
And been working on.
So with the packing and whatnot, you were just saying.
Yeah, basically a month I'd barely knit a stitch at all. And I gave myself one afternoon where I just said, right, I'm having a few solid hours of just knitting. I watched a movie, Bridget Jones' Baby.
Yep.
Didn't like it.
I didn't mind
it. I was really disappointed with the story.
Well, at least you grew up a bit.
She did.
Without any spoilers.
Without any spoilers. Yeah. I think her choices were wrong. If you want to talk about it off in other spaces, we can talk about it. Hey, on the Ravelry group.
We love movies.
We have a Ravelry group.
You have a Ravelry group.
We have a Ravelry group. So let's
I don't think I'm a friend of you on Ravelry group. That's just rude. How did I
almost all unpacked apart from my study / craft room / home inside home. So what I hope to do is, now that that's all pretty much sorted, is spend much more time knitting and crafting, and just quietly I'm going to learn to sew.
Have you got a sewing machine?
I've got a sewing machine and an overlocker. I got them from Aldi of all places.
I look forward to that. Have you seen Sonia's finished dress?
No.
Oh, okay. So Sonia is the lady who started our knit group, the Richmond Knitters, and she's on Instagram as the Richmond Knitters, Richmond Knitters. And we meet every Monday night at the Spread Eagle pub in Richmond.
And that's actually how Deb and I met in the first place, just after I moved down from Brisbane about 3.5 years ago.
No.
Yeah. And yeah.
We might have just got our puppies then. They're 3 years old now.
I don't think you had. No. You didn't have either of them.
Got a Scotty and a Westie.
They're babies. They're so adorable. I can't wait to get
them. So we've jumped around.
We have.
Sonia has started. She got her sewing machine for Christmas. And she's knit some beautiful project bags.
I just dropped my phone on the floor.
pick it up. She got a sewing machine for Christmas and has made some beautiful project bags. Mm. She's just finished a dress and we've just seen a sneak peek of it.
Nice.
So.
I have made one project bag and I'm halfway through a second one.
Oh, awesome.
But
yeah. It takes a lot of work and you've got to keep it set up.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a lot of work to pull out and pick up and go if you don't have it set
That's
up.
It.
Like at my place, I can't have it set up.
Yeah. Now that I've got my own room, once I get some extra space up there, there's room for either a sewing table or putting in some IKEA benches along one of the walls. Having the PC in one spot and then the overlocker and sewing machine.
That'll work
swapping
lovely.
Them in and out. Yeah.
Will you move the podcast up there? Because we're currently in your living room.
Yes. So future episodes won't be here in this format. We'll be back up in front of the PC as I normally do them.
Yeah. Hmm. So you've got your dolly in the background. What's her name?
It's not Thatcher. A dolly. Thatcher. Oh, the metal dress form. Thatcher, the Iron Lady.
Oh! That's awesome. Have you actually said that?
Yeah.
We need to get back on track.
Deb, over to you.
Over to me. So my current whip, which has been going for a really long time, and a bit shamefaced, I started this as a cowl with Sonia, Richmond Knitters, and this is called I'll get the name again because it's, I've been calling it the wrong thing, I found out today when I did my research. So it's called the... So this is called the, wait there, I'll start again. So this is called the Stitch Block Cowl by Pearl Soho. And it starts off with all of this huge amount of knitting. And it goes in three sections. So the white is the first. Then I've got the blue and white. And it keeps going. They're 20 inches each section. And then I've got the last section, which is the three colours. So I'm probably about 10 inches from being finished, but my sky blue colour...
It's about 25 centimetres, I think.
Is it?
Yeah.
Got no idea. Goldfish. Google, that's what Google's for. So this ocean blue I've nearly run out of.
Okay.
So the white and the deep blue. So the colours, this is done in Madeline Tosh Vintage, and I've got
and that's a 10-ply,
I think so, yeah. I've got the little, the doobies.
Ball bands?
Yeah, I bought them so that I would know, but I didn't write that down, actually. Here it is. Tosh Vintage Worsted Weight.
Yep.
Worsted Weight. Or you can have it on the screen, whatever you want. So, where am I at? This is, so the white section, that's called Antler. The section, the second one, this light green, is, I think it's what they call Hosta Blue. I can't find the ball band. I've got all the other ball bands except for that one.
Not in your rev notes?
No. Usually I'm quite good, but I haven't been in the past year.
Yep.
No. And the dark blue green, which is awesome because it's like the sea where it lovely, changes colour. I've got the ball here. I'll pull it out to focus on.
Oh, that is my favourite colour.
It just goes from blue to green, and it's just looking blue at the moment, but it really has green,
quite tealy sapphire, turquoise, dark deep turquoise kind of color.
Yeah, and it's called, I don't know how to pronounce it, but it's called
Costo. Costo. We'll put it on screen and somebody else can tell us how to say it.
But that color, I would grab again because the green's in it. And even when I had a look at the Mad Tosh site today, when I was researching it, it comes up as a navy blue, but the greens in there are amazing. And that's why I think the best way to describe it is the ocean, that deep blue with the deep green coming through, just gorgeous. And that's the one that I think's Hosta, H-O-S-T-A blue, Hosta blue. I think that's it.
And that's looking a little more green on screen.
Yeah,
I have noticed the colours that come up on the while filming are a little bit different sometimes.
Too. Yeah, that's not too bad.
That's not bad. That's pretty close.
Yeah,
that's lovely.
So these are very much my colours. That and red, white, and blue. So yeah, and this yarn, I was fortunate enough. Sonia and I went to Stitches West in February 2014, which is just outside.
2014.
Yeah. I know.
Which wasn't 15.
So I got this yarn at Stitches West 2015. Positive I saw the bag that said 2014. I want to go check it now. But anyway, 2015. Good luck cutting that. And we got this at Imagine It. So Sonia's done this beautiful fluoro colours. It's pink and yellow and just orange. And they're brilliant. And they work really nice with a wardrobe, which the way I'm describing it won't give it any credit at all, really, but it looks beautiful with her wardrobe. So she started hers February 2016. Yeah, you are right, it was 2015 because we started it a year after we went hello. So that's the other one, and I do want to share my project bag because I absolutely adore it. This is a purchase last year
and it's stunning.
This is a linen bag. And it's so soft and smooshy.
Let's have a look.
And it's called, it's got a thimble and acorn. Is the lady who's made it. And she's on Etsy. She's currently on holidays on Etsy as she's on maternity leave. There's cotton on the inside. And there's, and it's got a little yellow leather pull. And it's got really nice corners there where it pulls in. So. Love it. And I've got a smaller green linen one as well.
Oh, nice.
That fits a sock. And because it's smushy, the ball just sits in there really nicely. Yep. It's not fighting against the shape of the bag.
Yeah.
Oh, it's awesome. So that's a couple of my favourites. And that's one of my current whips.
Have you got any others you want to share?
Yes, I do. All right, get that one right out of the way.
Got another cute little bag.
Oh, yes. I'll show you lots of cute bags.
It might get lost.
I've got a big one of this too. I went back for more. So this is it's a little sock bag. This one's by
a little tag on the side.
Yeah, it's called Denica.
Denica Studio.
Denica Studio. So this one's by Denica Studio, and I got this from lovely little popcorn. I got this from Sunspun, which is a store in Canterbury, here in Melbourne. And then I got the larger one and probably another one from the nitpick site.
Oh yeah, yep.
And they're called cosmetic bags, but they're beautiful for knitting. It's a lot stiffer, but it just, it's perfect still, and it does crunch up. And I might be using some of them for cosmetic bags coming up, because the big ones are really quite stiff and long.
You can pack a fair bit in.
Yeah, you can pack a fair bit in, but it's more for the knitting bag. It can be a bit, probably a little bit more cumbersome than I thought. And this one's actually perfect for going in my handbag. So my second project, whip, is from Skein Yarn, and it is a, it's called Top Draw Sock, sock ply, sock four ply, and it's a 85-15 blend. So this one is a lovely greys and blues and rusty colours, and it reminds me of when you're driving in the countryside, that, you know, the sheds are corrugated iron sheds and the rust coming through and stuff like that. So I've got a bit of a thing for these colours at the moment, and I've done another one by Western Sky Knits recently that is a very similar
colour. Yes. So this one, chocolate in that one, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. Yeah. And this one's called Industrial Age.
Well, there you go.
Totally.
Yeah, a bit of that kind of coppery and the is it verdigris? Is that the
fancy
patina? You know when copper goes green. Yeah.
Did I say copper?
Yeah.
Stainless steel rust.
Yeah,
the rusty corrugated iron.
It is. I'm getting more of a
the copper. Yeah, gotcha. So, yeah, that's just a plain sock. It's what I'm working on. I actually started this in July, and it's just been sitting around. I'm doing it on tiny little needles, which...
Are they the Chowgu ones?
Probably.
Red cord?
Yes.
Yep.
Chowgu. But I'll be taking it off and using my Knit Pros. And I've just got it in a little keeper so it doesn't go through. And, yeah, just a normal... I'll go back to... What do you call it? Magic loop. And trusty, just easy.
You're not a fan of the minis?
I like the minis for the main parts.
Yep.
But the start, the corners and the toes.
I agree. I've found that I've been using them definitely for the heel turn. It's very difficult, and for the casting on getting that loop join. But once you pass those, it just flows.
Yeah, I just find the round and round and round really good. Like I knit that within... Well, it doesn't seem like much, but I knit that really quickly for me.
Yeah.
But this is actually for my husband, and I think it's about 74.
Oh, yeah.
74 stitches, or it could be a little bit more. I might have done 76, and that makes this easier up the top.
Yeah.
Because anything smaller, so if you're doing a 64 foot, I reckon this would be a struggle.
Yeah, what size are your needles?
They're 2.5s.
2.5s, yeah.
And I usually do the foot. Once I turn the heel, I do the foot at a 2mm now.
Okay.
And the 2.25 is, they say for 2.25, and the 2.5 is a US between a 1 and a 2, just for reference as well. So that's my second project. And just if you've never seen this before, I got this at Bendigo. And it's a sock keeper, and it's got any yarn, the needle cords just come out the top there. But it just means it doesn't damage any of my bags. It's all protected, and your sock will just sit on out here. So this is by a gentleman, Australian, called Spinning Woody.
Spinning Woody, yes.
Yeah, yep. And I would get more of these. I really like him. He wasn't at the show last year.
He was at the muster.
Oh, that's right. We didn't stay very long.
The muster is the spin-off. Yeah. To the Matt and Sheikh Mall show, which I think I've talked about in previous episodes. Basically, what its official name is the Artesian Woolen Textiles Show, I think, or something along those lines. And it's the fringe festival of the Australian Sheikh Mall show.
Yeah, it's just down the road. Mm. It's a short walk.
Yeah.
It's nice to get away from the main show and then go there and sit down and have a cuppa. And the local bowls club where they're at makes scones.
And they have all the vendors that are there are placed around the outside of the room. And then the middle is set up with tables and chairs and things so that you can just basically sit and knit and have your cuppa and your scone and so, you know, catch up with all your knitting buddies from across the country because we all go.
Yeah.
Are you going this year?
When haven't I gone? When I'm out of the country or something?
Yeah.
Travelling. I always make sure I've got the Friday off with work. My boss is a knitter, so she gets it and she tends to have the Friday off and goes as well, or if she can on the weekend, so she totally gets it.
Right. Let's pick up that story where we left off. What was I talking about? Oh, Bendigo. Yes. So the first time I went, three of my friends from Brisbane came down and we had a house in Bendigo for most of a week. And we're planning to do that again this year. We have a reunion tour.
Oh, sweet.
The band is getting back together. And so, yeah, I'll be taking a whole week off. We'll go down a couple of days before the show so the travellers can come in and have time to recover from travel. Not that it's, you know, an overly onerous trip from Brisbane to Bendigo, but, you know, it's nice to then unwind, relax, get the house set up, unpack as much as you want to. And have some solid crafting time without any pressure before hitting the show.
Yeah.
It also gives you a bit of time to think and plan about your strategy for shopping because you need to go to Bendigo with a strategy.
Sometimes you need the... You've already got either a big stash and you just want to enhance or you want to get yarn for certain projects, whether it be a jumper or you've got too much sock or not enough sock yarn. But the trip from Brisbane, for those who might know, is about 2 hours.
It's about, just about two hours to fly from Brisbane to Melbourne. And then it's about 2 hours, an hour and a half from the airport out to Bendigo.
It's a bit of a drive, but thankfully it's just full highway from the airport.
An hour and a half feels like nothing these days.
No, that's right, because you're at
the bridge.
So you're getting together and you've got a house.
Mm-hmm, we've got a house and it's, I think it's walking distance to the Bowls Club as well.
Oh, sweet, I wonder if we've stayed there 1 year.
Possibly.
Yeah.
So we found it on Airbnb, and I booked it in July, August. So
I need to book mine.
Snapped it up, If you're thinking of going to Bendigo this year and you want to do it seriously, things will be filling up quickly.
And not to put a downer on Bendigo, it's nowhere near the size of the American.
No.
If you're over... I haven't been to anything in Canada or the UK from a knitting experience, though hopefully, maybe one day. But from Stitches West to Bendigo, nowhere near as big. But it's just, I suppose from what I understand, it's kind of like Rhinebeck in that it's all about the sheep and the show. And this is the yarn experience is a sidekick to that.
Well, it's been slowly growing, I think, as more people have gotten back into the yarn and fibre arts. Because, it's not just about knitting. There's definitely the weaving side as well and spinning. A lot of spinning fluff and fibre is there for sale as well, and plus all the tools.
Is it Magic Craft who come over from New Zealand?
No, the other one, Ashford.
Ashford, yeah. And Ashford have a knitting retreat sometime during the year in New Zealand. And just reference again, from New Zealand.
Won't be doing it this year, but maybe. No.
The flight over there is 4 hours. And from
to where? Is it
somewhere in New Zealand?
Wellington,
I haven't been.
Or Auckland or
not sure.
It's about three. Well, it's about quicker flying there
than it is
around. It's quicker flying back to Australia because the Earth is spinning as you fly, so...
I can't get numbers and you're expecting me to keep up with you here.
What I'll do is I'll find the details for it and put a link in the show notes.
Oh, the show notes.
Yeah.
Everything will be there.
Okay. Do you have any more works in progress you'd like to talk about?
No.
No,
I've got lots of stash and stuff.
Okay. All right, well then, let's move on to our next segment. We good?
Finished objects.
We're going to finish objects from the vault. Kind of newish segment where instead of talking about recently finished objects, we're going way back to look at some things that we've finished obviously a lot longer ago. So Deb, would you like to start this time?
Yes, and I've got a selection of red and white going on here. The first one I have here is a Kate Davies design, and it's done in Jemison and Smith. 2-ply jumper weight, and this is the Ekelfecken mitts, which
sounds like a rude word.
I'm not swearing. I have consulted the internet as to the correct pronunciation. I've consulted a Scottish guy who I work with, who'd never even heard of it before. It's a little place in Scotland anyway, and we'll put the spelling on the screen, but from what I understand, it's called Ekelfecken, and it sounds really rude because these mitts actually cause me a lot of grief, and it's mainly because they're...
So there's a lot of Ekelfecken while
you were... There was tons of Ekelfecken. I just thought I was saying the name wrong at the beginning, and really what was... Yeah, when I did my research, that's what I... Look, that's probably an Aussie pronunciation of it, but I'm sure once it got the Scottish bro, you know, that accent into it, it'd be a lot more beautiful than the way I'm saying it. But this is 2 millimeter needles for the... It's a garter stitch. Sorry, I probably could go up closer. Garter. Yep, garter stitch border. And then you just knit straight, and I'll show you the join. It's a beautiful where they just carry the yarn, and it's a nice finish. So Kate Davies is the designer, which I think I've already said, but this is quite solid. You know, if I had done it at the gauge she'd recommended, it would have been, I'd slap you around and you'd be knocked out. So I went up to a 2.75 needle for the body here, and I probably could have gone to a 3 easily. It's just for the Australian winter and climate here, you don't want it too dense. Where I can understand over there, it'd be beautiful.
The snow, yeah.
It would be awesome in that nice dense fabric. So I frogged this so many times to get the right gauge, because once I went too small on this, it wasn't looking nice. When I went to larger needles or less stitches, and I ended up casting on 74 stitches and then adjusting a little bit of the pattern. So that worked for me. And like I said, I probably could have gone to larger needles, the 3s, I think.
Is that something normally you have to do, is size up your needles or?
No, but from what I understood from a lot of the research on Ravelry, the pattern itself, a lot of people had mentioned how dense it was.
Mm-hmm.
So, and that's just, I think, the preference or the way maybe she knits.
Yeah.
But for me, it was just a bit too much. Now, I wore these at Bendigo, and they were amazing. They were beautiful. It's 36 degrees outside today. With the
which is on. About 100 degrees Fahrenheit for anyone who still uses the old scale.
Yeah.
That's the only one I know.
That's the only one you know. It's horrible.
Yeah.
So not the best for today, though. It's beautiful in here. You've got the aircon on and it's lovely. But I love these. I want more. And I've gone to town purchasing Jemison. Yeah, I should put it on too, shouldn't I? That'll be hot.
A little bit.
And it's a bit tight. Mean.
It looks... It's more flexible once you have it on than what it looks. It looks quite stiff off the hand, but on hand, yeah.
My little thumb gets a bit lost in there, but I think that's good as well, because you can always tuck your fingers in or they'll go in your pocket. But just the pretty, it's just so pretty up there, the way the little red lines go.
And I'm finding that yarn a little bit scratchy.
It's because it's hot. As soon as it's winter, it does it. You don't even notice it.
Okay. I got quite sensitive skin to scratches though.
It'd be worthwhile. Because you know how people complain of scratchy jumpers and stuff? Mm-hmm. If it's in the right climate, it shouldn't be scratchy.
Okay. I'll try.
But I do know sensitive skin. That's a different level.
Mm-hmm.
But...
Yeah, I've got the conditioner test to try still on a scarf.
The other thing is, I haven't washed these or blacked these yet.
That could have something to do with it.
I finish it and I just chuck them on. So probably the stitches are a bit puffy still and haven't settled. so I need to take care of that. But love them. Totally would recommend.
And you've got another finished object there on your lap?
I do, but do you want to do yours?
All right. We are going way back, way, way back to...
Feathers.
Yes. about 2004, I think it would be, to the very first thing I knit as a grown-up.
Back in time.
It is horrible yarn. It is revolting yarn. I just look at it and I shudder. Look at this.
The colour is really pretty, quite good.
But it's acrylic fluffy yarn, which some people still knit with, so I guess I shouldn't complain about it too much. But you can see that there are drop stitches in the middle there. And
you've got no chance of picking that up either.
And yeah, this end is, you know,
wider than
significantly wider than the middle section.
You might have to hold it up a bit more.
Oh, yeah, sorry. That's the end. I think I...
And as you, if you yeah, hold that up.
I made this and then I didn't knit again for a few years.
The experience.
Yeah, I don't know. I kept trying and I made a scarf and a hat for when I went to England in a kind of a beige colour. And I think it was Peyton's yarn. And I didn't understand anything about, you know, dye lots or anything like that. And I had ended up with two different dye lots and the colours just, it was really obvious in places that they didn't quite match up. But first time I wore them out in England, I lost them. I was so upset. The hat fell out of my pocket.
Oh, yeah.
When I was in the supermarket, and obviously someone else decided to claim it for their own.
It's gone to the lost property box. You went back.
I went back and then I phoned them and yeah.
It's the most heartbreaking thing to lose. Yeah.
Yeah. And the scarf wasn't anything fancy. It was just a good old 2x2 rib, I think. Got it from Lincraft.
Our local. Yeah. Would you say a haberdashery?
A big box fabric yarn craft store.
Quality used to be amazing.
Yeah, it's a
bit
hidden.
We shouldn't bag it, should we?
No, it's better than Spotlight.
Yeah, better than Spotlight.
Which we shouldn't bag either, I guess.
No.
No bagging. Bag, hang on, no, yep. It's not a bag-free podcast. Honest review, this is an honest podcast. People will tell it how it really is.
Yeah.
Okay, and you look like you're ready to go.
Yeah, I've got my second... this project I actually finished just before Christmas. And they're socks for my husband. They haven't been worn yet. So it's a, what do you call it? The twisted rib, or I think it's a half twisted rib.
Is it a 1x1?
Yeah. 1x1 twisted
nice
rib.
Twisted, yeah.
Yeah. They say that there's two ways to twist it, front and back. Okay. I only do one twist.
On the knit stitch.
Yeah. Yep. I think so, because it just flows beautifully for me and that's my preference. And then the, I partridge heel.
Mm-hmm.
I looked it up earlier. You're not going to see that. It's red. It's going to blow out. Yeah, it's not as tomato red as it's looking. It's more a lipstick pink. And then, yeah, down to a kitchenette. But I just love it. Now, this yarn is from Yarn Enabler. And when you get it, it looks like this. I've got another skein. Can we see anything? Yarn Enabler. So it comes in with the red, which... heel and toe for your contrasting. So yeah, that's it.
Really clever.
Yeah, it's amazing and it's soft.
It's very very soft.
It was a pleasure to knit these.
Yeah,
and the stripes are beautiful. The yarn is soft. It's still tough though. And I did what I've said earlier in relation to socks. I went down to a 2 on the foot.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I might have even used 2 on the bottom and then a larger one on the top. No, I think I've used 2 millimetres. And then the top one a 2.5 or a 2.25 or something like that for up there. But it is beautiful yarn.
It is. And it's another 80% superwash merino, 20% nylon. And there's 115 grams here. So I'm assuming it's 100 grams in your big skein, 15 in your little. And you're getting 420 yards in total there.
Yeah. So these are for my, as I said, for my husband. The good thing to know about this is they're big.
Mm.
So that's probably about the 76 stitches again that I mentioned earlier. And they're really long. So I get to I basically know when I'm up to doing his toe is when I get to the end of my foot. So as soon as I get to the end of my toe, then I know I can start decreasing for his toe. So it's a bit of a hard slog because it's more stitches and it's longer. So I'm actually looking forward to knitting something for me because I did two pair of socks for him. One with the Western Sky, yeah, which is similar to the skein yarn, and that one. So, but I love these.
It's a beautiful colour. Yes. Thank you, Deb.
Probably more of that.
And yeah. I have another one from the vault as well. This one is another first project. A lot of my projects still feel like firsts. There's always something new.
When did you start knitting?
Seriously, in 2010, 2011, after a back injury. So I went from being a gym junkie to a knitter.
To a what?
From a gym junkie to a knitter.
Oh, okay.
So
it's an easy transition.
Yes. I don't remember the name of the pattern, so I'll put it in the show notes, but it is in my Ravelry projects.
It looks familiar.
I think it's a Fibonacci, maybe.
So the colours are perfect.
It's a triangle shawl which was knitted from the centre out, and the things that were new for me when I did it was it was my first garter tab cast on.
Don't you like that?
I really do like
it. Yeah, it looks pretty.
Yeah, so with a garter tab, yeah, you basically start in the middle with a few stitches and you work your way out and it grows as you go.
Yeah.
So it's a symmetrical triangle. No, it's slightly asymmetrical triangle because you're... maybe
so
that
that's
just a result
6 years
of
old.
No, this one I would have made it in 2011.
So 4 years old.
Yeah,
it's still in awesome
it's
condition.
It's in very good condition. The grey is a Began, which is a manufactured commercial yarn. Yeah, it's not very popular here in Victoria because I think Bendigo Mills trying to take over from it.
Okay.
In terms of, you know, it's kind of that similar popularity. It was kind of the workhorse yarn that was at my
in
local
Queensland
yarn store.
Yeah,
not just, it's not even that common in Queensland. I don't actually know where the mill is based, but
okay,
it was, yeah, the one that my local yarn store stocked. And then the multicoloured, which is purple and blues and pinks, is an Ischelle Bunny.
Ah, yes.
Yep, and I do not remember the colourway, but I do have it again stashed
in there.
I think
the mixture of that is gorgeous.
They do set each other off, and then the finish.
The mixture, you know what I mean. The colour blend is perfect. The tones and everything are perfect.
Yep, and that is coming up pretty true on screen. And now this, let's see if I can show it closely enough.
You probably have to hold a little
bit higher. I was trying to get the cast off.
There.
Let's do that. It was a 3-stitch I-cord bind-off.
I've
never
awesome.
Done an I-cord before of any sort.
That's perfect.
And, it took me 2 days. 2 days because I'm quite a... Because
you're a new knitter as
new
well.
New knitter, a slow knitter at the best of times, and wanting to get it just right as well. So,
but the benefit of doing that is the finish is really professional.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I haven't done that myself yet. We've done it on the big blanket projects we've done when people have got pregnant in our group or have moved home. We've had a few people go back to the UK, New Zealand.
And you've done an I-cord bind off on the...
On the blankets, yeah. We cursed the whole way. But it was just awesome.
Yeah.
It was, the end of that with the garter, you called it the garter?
The garter tab, yeah.
The garter tab and the bind off, it just looks really lovely.
Yep, and it's comfortable to wear. I tend to wear it sort of as a kerchief style rather than an over the shoulders.
Because it's long enough to get round and still. I like the fact it curls on the ends.
Mm. And you can get that by keeping your garter tab really tight.
Yep.
I'm a tight knitter at the best of times. Both yarns are really comfy to wear. So that always helps. But yeah, and that's it.
Very nice.
Yeah.
I think that's pretty good for an early on project.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, it's got your increases at the beginning all the way through it as well.
Yep, and then along the spine as well.
Mm.
So yeah, I would recommend this to someone who's ready for something that's a bit more than your basic scarf.
You want some more techniques, I suppose.
Yeah, it keeps it interesting. My one recommendation from this, and I do it on all my projects now, even if the pattern tells you not to, is at the spine, put in extra stitch markers, one on each side, so that
you can keep count. Yeah.
Usually they do tell you to put in one stitch marker so you know on the increase side always extra stitch markers, and also on the ends, you know, you'll get a pattern that says knit till 3 stitches before the end and then do your yarn over.
Mm.
I still put in an extra stitch marker there because, you know, when you're knitting and you're watching telly.
Yeah, it's a trigger.
yeah, it's just like, okay. It's the tactile clue that you've got to do something different from your bulk knitting.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that one's it. Okay.
New segment.
Yes.